Hello everyone. In this segment, we will try to understand the methods of dimension analysis. There are two methods as such. There are many, but we'll have a glance on only two methods. First one is Rayleigh's method, and the second one is Buckingham's pi theorem. Rayleigh's methods are applicable wherever you have the variables number less than 3, and it becomes tedious if n exceeds 3. Buckingham's pi theorem, on the other side, it is used very efficiently wherever you have n exceeding the number 3. So as far as this segment is concerned, we'll concentrate only on Rayleigh's method. The Rayleigh's method will solve a numerical problem. The problem statement is: find an expression for the drag force on smooth sphere of diameter d moving with a uniform velocity v in a fluid density rho and dynamic viscosity mu. The prerequisites to solve the numerical problems of dimensional analysis are a thorough knowledge on how to write the dimensions. So let us proceed with this numerical problem. According to this problem statement, which is very evident, that the drag force F is a function of diameter d, velocity v, density rho, and dynamic viscosity mu. So it's a function of. Now let us try to rewrite this equation. And I write this equation in terms of F equals to a constant into d to the power a, into v to the power b, rho to the power c, and mu to the power d. We have raised the powers of all these variables. F equals to some constant into all the other variables. Now this equation, whatever we have, F equals to constant into some more parameters, this equation is dimensionally homogeneous, and that's the main assumption here. So where C is a non-dimensional constant. Now if this equation, the previous equation, is a dimensionally homogeneous equation, then according to the statement of dimensional homogeneity, their dimensions on left hand side and right hand side written for each term, they should be equal. So we'll solve for dimensions. Now write the dimensions for the previous equation, this equation. F has a dimensions of m to the power 1, l to the power 1, t to the power minus 2. And C, anyhow, it does not carry any dimensions, or if at all you want to write, it is m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0. Diameter has a dimensions of length to the power a, so it's l to the power a. Velocity has the dimensions as l to the power 1, t to the power minus 1, whole to the power b. Density, m to the power 1, l to the power minus 3, to the power c. And the dynamic viscosity, m l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1, whole to the power d. Now, from this equation, if this equation is dimensionally homogeneous, and to say the dimensions of each terms are equal in this equation, we can equate the dimensions of powers of m, powers of l, powers of t. That is what we do here. Equating the powers of m on left hand side, power of m is 1, which is equals to, on the right hand side, power of m are c plus t. It is into, so it is c plus d. For L, it is 1 equals to a plus b minus 3c minus d. And for the last one, t, minus 2 equals to minus b minus d. Now, if you observe very keenly, we have three equations to solve. But there are 1, 2, 3, 4 unknowns, a, b, c, d, 4 unknowns. That means we have to express one unknown variable in terms of some other things. And we always go with the giving priority to the variables. For example, among diameter, velocity, density, and mu, viscosity has more importance here. So we express the viscosity is vital here, and hence A, B, C are expressed in terms of D. That is power to the viscosity. Okay, that means from this equation, C is written in terms of 1 minus D. B is written from the last equation, B is 2 minus D. Now we substitute C and B in the middle equation to calculate some more quantities. Okay, so by putting the values of these two variables C and B, I'll calculate A, and A is of this form, and A is, if you simplify, you'll get A equals to 2 minus D. Now just observe, A is 2 minus D, C is 1 minus D, B is 2 minus D, and D is D. So all the variables are expressed in terms of D here. Now for the further simplification, you substitute all the values of A, B, C, D in the basic equation, the equation which we assumed as a dimensionally homogeneous. A is 2 minus D, B is 2 minus D, C is 1 minus D, and D, anyhow, D is D. So just club the variables, parameters having the similar powers. D to the power 2 minus D can be written in terms of D to the power 2 into D to the power minus D. And that's how I've clubbed D to the power 2, V to the power 2, rho to the power 1. And you also have rho into D to the power minus D, V to the power minus D, rho to the power minus D, mu to the power D. Now D to the power minus D means 1 divided by D to the power D. V to the power minus D is 1 divided by V to the power D. Rho to the power minus D is 1 divided by rho to the power D. So further I will apply all these waveforms. So it is C into rho into D square V square into, just observe, mu to the power D on the numerator. Meaning of D to the power minus D is 1 divided by D to the power D. So I'll club all the terms which are having a common power D, and this is your final version. Okay, and F equals to, the drag force F equals to a new constant phi, rho into D square V square. To remove power D, we have introduced phi, a new constant, mu divided by rho into V into D to the power is 1 here.